The NBA draft evaluations has ended, and it's now time to look forward to NBA free agency. Maybe a while ago, a lot of teams didn't expect too much movement during free agency. But it seemed the closer we get to it, the more likely many stars will change teams. If the draft is about improving the future, then free agency is about teams getting better immediately. This year, I don't think that teams will be throwing money around like they did last year. Teams will most likely be more cautious and calculated, and I believe a lot of stars won't receive max contracts. With the team that Golden State has put together, players should realize that in order to compete with the Warriors, they need to sacrifice a little bit of their salary in order to put together the best team they can. In this video, I will give my free agency predictions for this year's class. First up, Blake Griffin. A couple of days ago, surprisingly, Chris Paul opted into his contract and was traded to the Houston Rockets to join James Harden. And the buzz going around is that Blake Griffin is just as good as gone. But I disagree. I believe Blake wanted to have the opportunity for the first time to lead the Clippers as the team's best player. The year when Blake Griffin finished in the top five for the MVP, Chris Paul was out for the majority of the season. Griffin played the best he ever did when Chris wasn't on the floor that year. But his injury history is a concern, and the fact that Blake Griffin might not even be available for the start of the season because of the toe injury he suffered in the playoffs might be enough to scare teams off like the Miami Heat and the Boston Celtics. I predict that Blake will sign close to a max contract with the Clippers for 4 or 5 years. Gordon Hayward has meetings set for the Miami Heat, Boston Celtics, and the Utah Jazz, so it should come down to those three teams. But Hayward to the Celtics just makes too much sense, and it's where he will be reunited with his college coach, Brad Stevens. The Celtics finished with the number one seed in the East last season. They desperately need another player or two who can create his own shot outside of Isaiah Thomas. Signing Hayward would be a significant long-term move for Boston. If the Celtics keep Jason Tatum, they could bring him along slowly as Hayward's backup, or they could use Tatum in a trade to pair Hayward with Paul George and form potentially one of the best teams in the league. Next up, Kyle Lowry. I believe the teams that will pursue Kyle in free agency are the Raptors, Spurs, and the Timberwolves. There was a report that Jimmy Butler was recruiting Lowry to Minnesota. My initial prediction for Lowry was him signing with the Philadelphia 76ers, but that went out the window when the Sixers traded up from 3-1 and drafted Markelle Fultz. I'm sure the Spurs have Lowry at the top of their list after Chris Paul was traded to the Rockets. But at the end of the day, I believe he will re-sign with the Raptors with a less than max contract. Maybe the changes the Raptors make will be on the trade market. They could trade their center, Giannis Valanciunas, for a better small forward or shooting guard and move DeRozan to the small forward. The Atlanta Hawks seem to be in rebuilding mode, and a report said that Millsap and the Hawks have had contact about the possibility of a sign and trade. Millsap has been linked to the Denver Nuggets, Boston Celtics, Miami Heat, and the Houston Rockets. I don't believe that the Rockets will land Paul George or Carmelo Anthony. I believe the Rockets and the Hawks will work out a sign and trade package that will send Paul Millsap to the Rockets to join Chris Paul and James Harden. He's an upgrade over Ryan Anderson as a more complete player on offense and defense. Ryan Anderson will definitely have to be in the trade, and maybe the Rockets will have to throw in a young player that they have drafted in the past to sweeten the deal. Jrue Holiday will be meeting with the Pelicans first at midnight on the first day of free agency. I believe he will not leave New Orleans without a contract. I don't believe Holiday will pass up an opportunity to grow with the two best big men in the NBA, in Cousins and Davis. And the organization stood by and supported Jrue when he dealt with the situation with his wife when he missed the start of the season last year. I believe all signs point to Jrue Holiday re-signing with the Pelicans to keep intact their three best players. And maybe Drew's brother Justin will join him in New Orleans to play with each other for the first time in the NBA. Stan Van Gundy and the Pistons have indicated that they plan on matching any offer sheet from other teams for a restricted free agent guard, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. He's the classic 3-and-D player who has gotten a little better every year. I wouldn't say he deserves to be a $20+ million a year player, but that's what he will most likely get. A team with a lot of cap space is the Brooklyn Nets. They pose the biggest threat to signing Caldwell-Pope. Are the Pistons bluffing to keep teams from offering a max deal so they can pay him less? I believe so, and I have Caldwell-Pope signing a max offer sheet from the Brooklyn Nets, and the Pistons will not match it. The Pistons will be way over the cap, and they're certainly not a contender in the East as of right now. Another restricted free agent on the Nets' radar is Wizards forward Otto Porter. Porter had somewhat of a breakthrough last season, as he averaged 13 points, 6 rebounds, and 1.5 steals per game while shooting 51% from the field, including 43% from three-point range. I think Brooklyn will focus more on Caldwell Pope, and the Wizards will be able to lock up Porter to a big contract to stay in D.C. That will put the Wizards over the cap and will only be able to improve the team by a trade. Maybe they can look to trade for an upgrade at the power forward position and pursue players like Paul Millsap or Serge Ibaka. Fresh off of winning his second championship, Iguodala will have a lot of suitors requesting for his services. With the Warriors concerned about the luxury tax moving forward, I believe there's a great chance Iguodala signs with another team. Andre is reportedly looking for a $20 million per year deal. A lot of teams are looking for a versatile veteran player with championship experience who can pass, score, and play great defense. I believe Andre Iguodala will go back to where it all began, back in Philly. I have Andre Iguodala signing with the team that drafted him, the Philadelphia 76ers. A veteran like Iguodala is just what the Sixers need. Veteran leadership is so important for teams full of young and talented players for growth and staying focused throughout a long season. Philly could be a definite playoff team with Iggy on the roster. They might be a playoff team anyway. If Gordon Hayward leaves Utah, there's no way that George Hill will re-sign with the Utah Jazz. I believe Hill's two top choices will come down to the San Antonio Spurs and the Minnesota Timberwolves. He could reunite with Popovich and go back to San Antonio for a chance to compete in the West with the Rockets and the Warriors. Or he could go to a young and prime Minnesota Timberwolves team who just added Jimmy Butler. There was a report that the Timberwolves were looking for better outside shooting at the point guard position. I have George Hill agreeing to a sign and trade with the Minnesota Timberwolves for Ricky Rubio. Hill will join the Timberwolves to bring more veteran leadership and outside shooting. A squad with Hill, Butler, Wiggins, and Towns could be a force to be reckoned with. I believe the writing was already on the wall, even before Chris Paul was traded, that J.J. Redick was leaving the Clippers. Redick could be a good addition for a lot of teams in today's NBA. The need for outside shooting is at an all-time high. I think a team that has no business signing a player like J.J. will offer him a lot of money, and Redick will sign. That team is the New York Knicks. Instead of preserving their cap space for the future, I believe the Knicks will sign J.J. Redick to a $15-plus million-a-year deal for around 3 to 4 years. Would you really be surprised if the Knicks signed a 30-year-old player to a big contract? Coming off a season where he averaged 18 points, 3 rebounds, and 4 assists a game, Derrick Rose can still help a team due to his constant pressure he puts on the defense through penetrations. He's coming off 4 knee surgeries, including one in April, but he did play 64 games last season. I believe that D. Rose will sign with the San Antonio Spurs. This is a good spot for Rose at this point of his career. Given the organization's success in resting players before, things could work out between Rose and the Spurs. He could split time with young stud DeJounte Murray at point guard. Averaging around 30 minutes per game would be a perfect plan for Derrick Rose, so he could have a better chance at surviving the season, and he can stay fresh throughout the season also.